two NBA titles, a 22-game winning streak, and the nickname Clutch City. Let's take a step back to learn the history of the Houston Rockets. As a part of the NBA's expansion plan in 1967, two new teams were added to the league, the Seattle Supersonics and the San Diego Rockets. Then in 1970, the Rockets picked Rudy Tomjanovich and Calvin Murphy, went on to be Hall of Famers that spent their entire career with the Rockets franchise. The team moved on to Houston in 1971 due to a change in ownership, making them the first NBA team in the state of Texas. The following season, for just two first-round draft picks, the Rockets landed a future Hall of Famer, Moses Malone, nicknamed Chairman of the Bulls. Malone started his era with a bang, leading the team to their first Eastern Conference Finals appearance. While they missed the playoffs in 77-78, the Rockets bounced back in the 1978-79 season. They won 47 games, and their leader, Malone, won the regular season MVP, the first such award in franchise history. In 1981, the Rockets stunned NBA fans when they became just the second team to reach the NBA Finals despite a losing record in the regular season. The following season, Malone won the regular season MVP, his second in 4 years. In the 1983 NBA draft, the Rockets picked Ralph Sampson, a 7'4" phenomenon. Sampson finished the season with averages of 21 points and 11 rebounds per game, earning him the Rookie of the Year award. The Rockets placed their trust in a Nigerian origin 7-footer by the name of Hakeem Olajuwon from the hometown University of Houston. Hakeem, the dream Olajuwon, went on to have a legendary 17-season career winning championship, an MVP trophy, a Finals MVP, and a Defensive Player of the Year award. Sampson and Olajuwon showcased their dominance over the league in the 84-85 season, earning them the nickname the Twin Towers. The team created history by upsetting the reigning champions LA Lakers in 5 games in the Western Conference Finals to reach their second NBA Finals. Then they stormed the next season with a franchisee record 55 wins and Olajuwon winning the Defensive Player of the Year. And then, in 1993, things got even better. They won a new franchisee high 58 games and clinched the second seed in the West. Olajuwon snagged the first MVP and second Defensive Player award of his career. They took care of business in round one, beating the 7-seeded Trailblazers in 4 games. Next up, 3rd-seeded Phoenix Suns, who were led by the previous season's MVP, Charles Barkley. The first 2 games saw the Rockets blow 2 commanding fourth-quarter leads at home against the Suns. The Houston Chronicle was not kind. Choke City, read the headlines of the local daily. This was fuel enough for the Rockets. The team fired off stunning performances and won 3 games in a row, and then won Game 7 back at home to clinch the series. The Rockets, on a streak from the series against the Sun, had no trouble taking care of business in the Conference Finals, beating the Utah Jazz and their star duo Karl Malone and John Stockton in 5 games to reach their 3rd-ever NBA Finals. And as they say, 3rd time's a charm. Things weren't easy, as the Rockets lost 2 games in a row and found themselves down 3-2 after Game 5. After 2 more hard-fought games where they traded punches with the New York Knicks on June 22nd at the Summit, the Houston Rockets became NBA champions for the first time. With 2 7-game series wins in their pockets, the Rockets were now Clutch City. The title was complemented by another historic feat. Hakeem Olajuwon became the first player to win the title, the Finals MVP, the regular season MVP, and the Defensive Player of the Year in the same season. Enter Clyde Drexler from the Portland Trail Blazers. Reunited with Drexler, his old teammate from the University of Houston, Olajuwon led the Rockets to 47 wins and the 6th seed in the West. Once again, Clutch City upset the 3rd-seeded Utah Jazz in 5 games to face the Suns. The conference semifinals brought back unpleasant memories. the Rockets faced elimination, down 3-2 after Game 5. Once again, however, the Rockets closed on the series with two back-to-back wins to defeat the Suns. The Western Conference Finals was a Texas showdown. No problem there. Olajuwon outplayed regular season MVP David Robinson and beat the Spurs in six games to reach their second finals in two seasons. The young Orlando Magic, led by Shaquille O'Neal and Anfernee Penny Hardaway, were making their first finals appearance. Their youth came up short against the veteran Rockets team, who swept the first-timers and took home their second NBA title in just two seasons. The team also created history by becoming the lowest-seeded team to ever win an NBA title. In 1996, looking to add another superstar to their roster, the Rockets traded in 33-year-old Charles Barkley, a former MVP who was on the quest for his first ring. Olajuwon, Barkley, and Drexler became the Rockets' big three. Despite an injury-ridden season in which they trotted out the oldest team in the league, Houston finished third in the Western Conference with 57 wins. The team's playoffs run was halted at the Western Conference Finals by the Utah Jazz. Led by regular season MVP, Karl Malone. With Clyde Drexler retiring in 98, the Rockets were once again on the hunt for a star. The answer came in six-time NBA champion, Scottie Pippen. The Rockets did improve, finishing with the fifth seed, but were once again knocked out in the first round. The 99-2000 season was a gloomy end to the Rockets' 90s era. The only saving grace that season was a trade bringing rookie Steve Francis, a draft day deal that involved three teams and 11 players. Francis went on to share the 2000 NBA Rookie of the Year award with Elton Brand. He also finished as the runner-up in the 2000 NBA Dunk Contest. By now, Olajuwon felt he gave the city and the franchise all he could and requested a trade. For all he did, the team honored his request, trading him to the Toronto Raptors. The Rockets once again landed the first pick in the 2002 NBA Draft. With Hakeem gone, they needed a new linchpin. Enter Yao Ming, the first non-American player to be drafted with the first pick. Ming created history. Not only was Ming tall, he was 7'6" and deftly skilled. He was also a star. His signing blew open a whole new market for the NBA in China. An estimated 200 million eyeballs tuned in to watch Ming take on O'Neal for the first time. Ming became an instant icon in China and a pop culture phenomenon in the USA. So big was his influence over the game in China that in 2004, the NBA became the first American professional sports league to host games in China. From the 2003-2004 season, fortune seemed to turn for the franchise. A new logo was to signify the start of a new era. The team added NBA scoring champion Tracy McGrady, acquired in a seven-player trade that sent Francis to the Orlando Magic. The season ended in a first-round exit, but it featured one of the most iconic moments in NBA history. On 9 December 2004, the Rockets were up against state rivals, the San Antonio Spurs. The Rockets seemed out of the game, trailing 76-68 with less than a minute to go. Everyone counted them out. Everyone but McGrady. There's no words that can describe what happened next. In 2007, the Rockets brought in the offensive-minded coach, Rick Adelman. This proved to be a spark that lit a flame. With Ming and McGrady, who were battling injuries, the Rockets pulled off one of the greatest accomplishments in the history of not just the NBA. From January 29, 2007 to March 16, 2007, the Rockets went on a 22-game winning streak. The fourth longest winning streak in NBA history. The Rockets made the playoffs just twice in the five seasons between 2007 and 2012. The only standout moment came in Game 3 of the 2009 Western Conference Semifinals against the Los Angeles Lakers. Ming, who was harboring an injury and was clearly in pain, refused to leave the court and willed his team to a victory. The 2011-12 season was to be the last for head coach Rick Adelman and was the end of the Yao Ming era. In 2017, Ming was inducted into the Hall of Fame and his jersey number 11 was retired by the franchisee that same year. Enter the James Harden era. The new threads and new situations helped unleash the phenomenon that is James Harden today. Harden, along with Jeremy Lin and Chandler Parsons, led the Rockets to their first playoff berth in four seasons. In 2013, the Rockets signed free agent Dwight Howard. The Howard signing paid off, and the Rockets finished with 54 wins and the fifth seed in the West. Things got better next season, though. The Rockets finished with 56 wins and were the second seed in the West. They cruised past their state rivals, the Dallas Mavericks, in five games and found themselves up against the formidable LA Clippers in the second round. And boy, did they leave it all on the floor. Trailing 1-3 after four games, the Rockets faced not one, not two, but three elimination games. They won all three, a feat not featured since the 1997 NBA playoffs, where the Miami Heat got the upset against the New York Knicks. In the summer of 2016, the Rockets hired the offensive genius of Mike D'Antoni. D'Antoni wasted no time in fortifying his three-point lineup by signing Eric Gordon and Ryan Anderson. Together with GM Morey, D'Antoni ushered in a new era for the NBA. During his four seasons as head coach, Houston led the NBA in number of threes attempted every season. The Rockets finished with 55 wins and the third seed. D'Antoni rightfully earned himself the Coach of the Year award. The 2017-18 season saw another change in ownership with Tillman Fertitta. Bought the team for $2.2 billion, a record price for an American professional sports team at the time. Morey continued to help solidify the roster, bringing in all-star guard Chris Paul from the LA Clippers in exchange for seven players and draft picks. With a star guard duo of Harden and Paul surrounded by a supporting cast of Gordon, Clint Capella, and PJ Tucker, among others, the Rockets set a franchisee record with 65 wins for the season. On March 29th, well before the regular season ended, they clinched the number one seed for the first time in franchise history. This time around, with a new-look formidable roster, the Rockets wanted to make no mistakes in the playoffs. They quickly got to work, beating both the Minnesota Timberwolves and the Utah Jazz in five games each. The Warriors, their conference finals opponent, fell behind the Blazing Rockets 2-3. However, much to the Rockets' poor luck, Paul suffered a hamstring injury in Game 5 and missed the last two games of the series. The Warriors took Game 6 from the shorthanded Rockets, setting up a Game 7 in Houston. The Rockets took charge on home court and held an 11-point lead with a little under 9 minutes to go in the third quarter. But poor shooting the rest of the way, coupled with a spirited comeback from the Warriors, saw the Rockets fall behind and eventually lose the game by 9 points. It was heartbreak for Harden and the Rockets, who believed and trusted in him since the day they signed him. He became the third player in franchise history to win the MVP trophy. Ahead of the 2019-20 season, just after two seasons with the franchise, the Rockets decided to trade Chris Paul. In a trade with the Oklahoma City Thunder, the Rockets received Russell Westbrook for Paul. Harden was now reunited with his Thunder teammate, and the Rockets again had lofty ambitions. Coach D'Antoni implemented a system that relied less on big men and instead focused on a combination of driving to the hoop or shooting threes, all while one talented guard, either Harden or Westbrook, held the ball. Seems shocking, right? Taking emphasis away from taller, bigger players in the game of basketball? They doubled down on their idea, trading away Capella in return for Robert Covington, an elite defender who could knock down the three ball as well. the Houston Rockets shook up the NBA with their new style of play. They were on a roll, both literally and figuratively. The bet seems to be working. In February, Westbrook and Harden became the first teammates in NBA history to average 30-plus points and 5-plus assists per game. As games resumed after the COVID lockdown, the Rockets managed to clinch the fourth seed in the Western Conference. The Rockets came up against the Oklahoma City Thunder in round one of the 2020 NBA playoffs. The Rockets pulled away in a tough-fought seven-game series. They faced up against the mighty Lakers, featuring LeBron James and Anthony Davis. Despite the Rockets' small ball heroics and the heralded James vs. James matchup, the Lakers prevailed in the seven-game series and went on to win the NBA championship. Prior to the start of the season, the Rockets traded Westbrook to the Washington Wizards in exchange for John Wall and a first-round pick. After 8 years, an MVP trophy, 8 All-Star selections, and 3 scoring titles, Harden requested a trade. On January 14, 2021, in a blockbuster trade, Harden was traded to the Brooklyn Nets. Since the trade, the wins have only been trickling in. However, the Rockets are building towards a future. The past season saw 5 of their players finish in double-digit scoring. 20-year-old Jalen Green is now considered by many to be the de facto face of the franchise, averaging 22 points a game. And along with 22-year-old Kevin Porter and a 19-year-old rookie, Jabari Smith Jr., the trio will carry the expectations of the Houston franchise. The franchise boasts of the youngest squad in the league with an average of just 22.1 years old. They led the NBA in offensive rebounds at 13.4 per game and finished fourth in total rebounding with 46.3 per game. This was a huge leap from finishing last in that category last season. The high-flying squad also finished the season with 523 made dunks, the second highest mark of the NBA, just behind the Cleveland Cavaliers. With a group of gifted and talented young players, sharing time on court with veterans and looking up to the rafters filled with memories of Clutch City, there is much to be excited for the future of the Houston Rockets.